We know who they are. Two senior citizens found buried in the yard of a South Daytona home. The question now, how did Goldie Robinson and Arthur Sheldon die and why? West 2's Claire Metz has the very latest in the suspicious death investigations.
Goldie Robinson's family hoped for the best, feared the worst when a second body was found in her mobile home park next to the home of a person of interest in the case. Their fears were realized. Now they want the rest of the story. Police tried yet again to get it from Kimberly Smith in the Orange County Jail on unrelated charges. Smith was self-appointed caretaker for both Goldie and the first person found buried, 67-year-old Arthur Sheldon. But she wasn't talking yesterday after suffering a seizure and hitting her head. Smith has a long financial criminal history dating back more than two decades. Was she stealing from Robinson and Sheldon?
They both had direct deposit of whatever income they had coming in. And that's part of what the financial guys are looking into.
We know Goldie was last seen by family in early July. There was activity on Goldie's ATM card into August, long after authorities believe Goldie vanished. And by then, Smith's extended family had moved into Goldie's place, fabricating a story that Goldie ran off and got married, gave them her home. Police continue to wonder if Smith alienated other seniors from loved ones.
There could be families out there right now that don't know that their relatives are missing, that may have been friends with. I don't know. We don't know.
Sources tell West 2 Ms. Robinson and Mr. Sheldon did not suffer blunt force trauma. Still, whether they died at someone's hand or naturally, they were unnaturally dumped here. Police detectives are getting help in the investigation from the state attorney's office. Short of someone admitting what happened here or more definitive information from the medical examiner's office, police will continue to follow the money. In South Daytona, Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.